guys, welcome back to the channel. Today's video is gonna be about my 6 month ownership on my 2019 Chargers Cat Pack. I bought the car early this year on March. Now it's October, so I had it for a little bit over 6 months now. I haven't really have any major problems with the car. At the beginning of the ownership, I noticed, and this was like a week after I had the car, that in order for me to go straight, the steering wheel was a little bit tilted to the side. So I called the dealership, took the car back in, they did an alignment and the issue was corrected. After, I wanna say a month and a half after that, I noticed, and then when I was braking, the car was pulling to the left. And I went online, did some research, because it was kind of weird to me. It's a brand new car, literally. And I did notice some people were complaining about the brake calipers, the Brembo brakes. This car does come with the Brembo brakes. Not sure if they all do. And then they told me to bring it in at the dealership, that they were gonna do a check on the brake calipers and alignment to see if everything was fine with it. I took the car back to them, they did an alignment, and they said that the brake calipers were perfectly fine. There was no issues with them. Besides those two things, nothing really major. I did had an issue with my trunk. The trunk light was coming on and off, saying that the trunk was open while I was driving. It's funny, but it only happened when I had the car in track mode. I don't know if it was a vibration or that I was driving it too hard or something. I didn't took it back to the dealership. All I did was I opened it up, I looked to see if there was something in between that was preventing them from closing completely. It seems fine. I opened it and closed it a few times, light was off, and that was, I wanna say, probably 3 months ago. Light has not come back. Transmission-wise, a lot of people have been complaining about transmission with these cars. I actually met a guy that he said his brother has one and he's been at the dealership a couple times. Maybe it's the older models. This one, not a single problem. And I do take the car to the track. I don't drive it hard every day. I actually don't even daily drive this car, but I don't drive it soft either. I do use the power that the car comes with. And so far, not a single issue with transmission, no check engine lights or anything. I wanna show you guys now the interior so you guys can see how it look. I got the upgraded interior. It's the Cat Pack Plus with the suede interior, ventilated seats. The dashboard for 2019, I believe they changed it, because before was like really plastic looking. Now it's like a rubber. It feels a little bit nicer. It gives you a look that is a little bit more expensive, the feeling. And everything else on the inside is technically the same. The brake pedals, those I think they come with Cat Pack and Hellcats. I don't think they come with the RTs. If you guys buy the car at the dealer, make sure they put those things on, because the brake, it's a headache, the brake one to put it on. I was dealing with it for like 30 minutes, so it's not easy to put on. They tell you it is, but it's a lie. Let me go ahead and turn it on now so you guys can see the screen, you know, all the features that comes with the screen and everything like that. It does have the big screen. It's the, I don't know if it's 8 inches or something like that. You do have a whole bunch of different features on the driver modes. You have different things, like right now it's on auto. Every time you start it, it's on auto. You have your custom mode, which you know, you can customize it however you like. You can see that I have different things. Sport mode, everything is sport, and then track is literally track. On the performance pages, which is loading right now, it does take a little bit of time to load the performance pages. I don't know if it happens on every single car. On mine, at least, it does take a while. Now, on this page, you can set up a whole bunch of different things. You can see the gauges. You can change what gauges you want to see. You can see horsepower, what gear you on, the G-force. You also have a dyno page in it, which is really cool. I never use the dyno page because the car is bone stock, so I don't really know what could I do with it. Another thing, if once you rev it, and I don't know if it's only on Chargers, I don't know if the Hellcat has the same issue, as you can see, it would not pass 4,000 RPMs. That's only when you are in like parking or neutral. Now, you're pulling on drive, you can redline it as much as you want, but on parking, doesn't do it. So you can see the car has 5,000 miles unchanged. This is the gauges I was telling you guys about. The way I have it set up, it's HP, torque, G-force, and current gear. You also have timers, gauges, and a whole bunch of other different options that you can see in the screen on the car. As you guys can see, the interior holds really nice. I only have 5,000 miles in the car, so I don't really drive it that much. But you know, it looks really nice. The leather, it's still holding out. It has a few cracks there on the side, but you know, it's normal, not a big deal. Everything else on the interior looks great. I love the way it looks. No scratchers. The leather looks perfectly fine. It's a little bit dirty. I usually keep it really clean. I did wash it on the outside today, but I was not feeling like the outside, like the inside, I'm sorry. The back seats, they have a lot of room, to be honest with you. It's a big sedan, so it's expected to have leg rooms in the back seats. They do have heated seats on the back, so that's really nice on winter. Down here in Florida, not a big deal. Here's a trunk. It's a huge trunk. I never had such a big trunk in any car before, but it comes in handy when you want to put, you know, suitcases, or you're going to travel with the family or things of that nature. It does comes in handy having such a large trunk. So overall, it's been a great car to me. Don't really have any major complaints about it besides the alignment problems that I had at the beginning. Again, this is the 2019 Scat Pack 6.4 liter Hemi, 485 horsepower. It's a pretty fast car. A lot of people think, you know, because it's a heavy car, it's not fast, but believe me, it's a fast car. I have taken it to the track and it does really, really good. I don't have drag radios. All I have is my Nitto's 555s. And I think my best time was a 12.4 at the track. I have said it on my previous videos before that I will be doing videos at the track. The first time I went, I didn't record anything that was worth to put on the channel. So this Friday, I'm planning to go. Stay tuned, because I'm gonna be racing my buddy's Camaro SS. It's a 2018, I think. And my brother Mustang GT is also a 2019 as mine, but he's got the 6-speed manual transmission. So that's gonna be a little bit different and a challenge for him to take off. And also, I will be doing some videos reviewing different types of car. I will be reviewing a Mercedes, my brother's Mustang. So stay tuned on the channel for more videos. If you guys like the content, go ahead and give me a like and subscribe to the channel. I really appreciate the support. This is it for today's video, guys. Stay tuned. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.